let's talk about DHCP protocol. Okay, so this is a layer 7 protocol. So layer 7 protocol means that it will be either using the TCP at layer 4 or UDP at layer 4. Okay, so this is basically a service which is utilized at layer 7. Okay, so at layer 7 means that it should be having some sort of port numbers. Okay, so in layer 4 header, there will be a source port number and the destination port number, correct? So DHCP basically uses two port numbers, which is 67 and 68. One is for DHCP client and other is for DHCP server. So 67 is for server and 68 is for client. Now let's talk about what DHCP service is used for. So let's say you are having a PC. So in your PC, there are two ways to define an IP address. The first way to define an IP address is you will go into your adapter. Okay. So adapter can be Ethernet adapter or the Wi-Fi adapter. Okay. And you can manually assign an IP address. You will manually give the IP. Let's say I give 192.168.1.1 and then you will give the subnet mask. Okay. And after that, you will be giving the gateway. Okay. So all this information you are providing manually. Okay. And the second way to provide an IP address to a PC or any device is dynamically. So dynamically means that you are not using, you are not providing an IP address manually. You will be using some sort of protocol or service. Okay. So the service which is used to provide an IP address dynamically to any device, that service is known as DHCP. So the full form of the DHCP is Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. So let's see how the DHCP works. Now, as I told you, there will be a DHCP server and there will be a DHCP client. So client is the one who is requesting for the IP address, means who requires an IP address. So in this case, my laptop is a client. Okay. And DHCP server will be the device who is providing the IP address. Okay. So let's look into the packets. So let's say this is your PC and this PC is connected to a switch. And then the switch is connected to a DHCP server. Now PC doesn't know that what is the IP address of the DHCP server. Okay, because PC wants to send their packets on the interface. I told you that if you are having a protocol, if you are using a protocol, which is layer 7, which is greater than layer 2. Okay, so it will be having the layer 2 header, it will be having a layer 3 header, and below that it will be having a layer 4 as well, because this is a layer 7 protocol, and under that it will be having a layer 7 header. So all the headers will be there because this protocol is a layer 7 protocol. Okay, now PC at layer 2, what information it will add? Okay, it will add its own MAC address as a source MAC. So let's say this PC MAC address is A. Now, as this PC doesn't know about the DHCP server, it doesn't know about what is the DHCP server, what is the IP address of DHCP server, what is the MAC address of DHCP server. So for destination MAC address, it will put the broadcast MAC address. So broadcast MAC address, for now, I'll tell you, it will be all Fs. Now at layer 3, it is not having an IP address. So at the source IP, it will put all zeros. Because this device is not having any IP address yet, it has to request for the IP address. Okay. So at layer 3, it will be putting the source IP as all zeros. So what will be the destination IP? Now broadcast IP address will be 255.255.255.255. Okay. So this is the broadcast address at layer 2 and this is the broadcast address at layer 3. So at layer 4, the source port will be, what will be the source port? So source port number will be 68 and destination port number will be 67 because this is the server port number. Okay. And at layer 7, there will be a DHCP header. So let's look into the flow, how the flow looks like. So there will be a DORA process. So the first packet which the PC will send will be a discover packet. Now the server will reply back with the offer. Offer will contain the IP address. Okay, so this PC, this server, DHCP server, will contain a database from which it will provide an IP address to the PC. Okay, so it will contain a database and it will provide an IP address from that database to this PC, and that we will be doing the configuration on the DHCP server. Okay, so in the offer, the DHCP server will reply back with the IP address. Now, if this PC will accept that IP address, it will send a request message. Now, the third message which will be sent by the PC will be request. Okay, so the request message will contain that, yes, I want this IP address that you offered me.
Hi, you are watching the recording from one of our live session. Hit like, share and subscribe for more future updates.
Okay. So once the DHCP server will receive the request message, it will send the acknowledgement. Okay, so these are the four messages that are being used by the DHCP server to provide an IP address dynamically.